Listen, students, on killing a tree, that poem was done. So we were discussing question answer of that poem. So can a simple jab of the knife kill a tree? Why not? We were discussing that question. So jab of the knife, it means if you hit one of the tree using any of the knife, will you be able to kill that tree? Okay, why not? What is the reason behind that? What is the reason behind that? Okay, it's not strong. Any other reason? Yes, it takes so much. Yes, okay. Very good. Yes. Yes, it requires. It requires a lot of efforts to kill a tree. Why so? There are so many reasons. Let's discuss about all these reasons. It took 100 of years. Yes. It took so many years. So many years to grow. Yes. Roots are spread. Yes, beneath the earth's crust. Okay. Roots are spread beneath the earth crust. Yes, it has. Yes, it has consumed nutrients. Which kind of nutrients? Like air, water, and sunlight. Air, water, and sunlight. So it has accumulated all those things. Okay. So with the passage of time, it has become so strong. It has, with the passage of time, became strong. So only single jab of a tree would not be sufficient. Only single jab of a tree would not be sufficient to uproot, to kill that tree. Yes. So you can pick up all these points. Some of the points you write on your own. Okay, from online class. Endured means tolerated. Okay, Dhiren, you tell me this answer.
Its strong roots, which is developed by burning in the sun in the cold winds and wet rain, its strong roots cannot be killed by a single jab.
Okay. Yes, Dhiren, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. No, a simple jab of knife cannot kill a tree. Yes, it will give the mighty tree some pain and some cuts on it, but the furious jab won't be able to break the bark of the tree. The bleeding bark will heal with time, and that furious tree would endure the pain. Some efforts or jab of just a couple of seconds can't kill efforts of so many years. The roots of the trees are beneath the earth's crust, and the tree has grown from so many years, consuming all the nutrients like sun, air, and water, and it becomes strong. So a simple jab of knife cannot do so.
Good. So same answer, Simran, you tell me.
Which is stored since
Okay. Same answer. Reza, you tell me. Okay, now let's move to next question. Next question we have is, what is the meaning of bleeding bark? What makes it bleed? Sorry. Second question, how has the tree grown to its full size? List the words suggestive of its life and activity. Same point you can take. So words can be, so same answer will be you telling, but you have to tell some of the words of its life and activity. For its life and activity, which words will be used? For its life, which words will be used? It is?
It burns in the sun.
Same points you can pick up to frame near about 80% answer, but you have to tell that which words are suggestive for life and activity. From which word it seems that his life is going on. Yes, very good. Feeding. Then. Very nice. Absorbing.
Bleeding bath,
it symbolizes that it is going to be killed from that. From poem, you have to pick up the word.
Browning, hardening.
Yes, sprouting.
Browning, hardening, twisting, and withering in the sun.
But these things are telling that it is going to be killed. I'm telling about that words which tell about its life. Yes, very good. Consuming. Yes, only words you have to mention that from these words, yes, rising. So from these words, it is crystal clear that tree is having a life. Withering means decay. It is not decay. Decay means to come to an end. Okay, sprouting leaves, yes. Sprouting leaves. So from these words, we can say that it has life. It is consuming, it is absorbing, it is feeding, it is sprouting leaves. So all these words are symbolizing life. Okay, now next question we have. Next question is, what is the meaning of bleeding bark? What makes it bleed? What is the reason that it started bleeding? Yes, when somebody was trying to kill it. Somebody hit it hard. Then what happens? Excuse me. Yes, it feels a lot of pain. Yes, it starts bleeding and something liquid, just like secretion, comes out. It starts oozing out of its body. Oozing out means it started coming out of its body. And it seems that it is paining. Some liquid is coming out. It is a blood. Okay, it has pain. So this is known as bleeding bark. So I'm going to elaborate each and every one. Tell me. So first of all, you have to tell what is the exact meaning of bleeding bark. So bleeding bark, it is basically a liquid, or you can say secretion that comes out of a bark of a tree. Comes out of a bark of a tree. And when this liquid comes out of a tree, when it is hit hard and it ooze out. Ooze out means comes out. Some liquid ooze out, it comes out, okay, and it seems just like a, it seems that tree is hurt, feeling pain, feeling pain, and some liquid comes out, ooze out, secretion is there, okay, and this all is known as bleeding bark, okay. So what makes it bleed? What is the reason why it started bleeding?
When it is bleeding hard.
Yes, when it is, you can say hurting. Hurting, yes, very good. Chopping. Hacking. So all these process cause this. When we do chopping, when we do hacking, when we hurt, when we hit it, in place of hurting, you can write down hitting. I have written wrong. It is basically hitting. So hitting, chopping, hacking. Hitting, chopping, hacking. All these process cause the tree to bleed. Clear? Hitting, chopping, and hacking. These are the reasons that make the tree bleed. Clear? Am I clear with this? So Ikjot has written so well. Bleeding bark means the twigs which cut mercilessly. They leave a liquid substance. If any part of the human body is cut, it starts bleeding. In the same way, the liquid substance comes out from the branch of a tree. Okay, the human being's acts makes it bleed. Very nice. Ikjot, well written. So this answer is clear. Shall I move further? You all have written this answer?
Yes.
Next question we have is, the poet says no in the beginning of the third stanza. What does he mean by this? So you read third stanza carefully. In the very beginning he says no. So what actually the meaning of no here is? Yes, it means hacking, chopping, cutting, hitting hard, to hit with the jab, all these are not adequate. Not sufficient. In place of sufficient, you can write down inadequate also. Yes. So these all processes are not at all adequate, sufficient to kill a tree. It is not properly killed. It is still surviving. So these processes, hacking, chopping, cutting, hitting hard, to cut with a jab, to cut using an axe, all these processes are not going to kill a tree. So that's why he is putting emphasis, he is putting stress on the word no. So you can write down here, he is putting emphasis. Yes, he is putting stress on the word no.
Ma'am, hacking and chopping cannot pull out the tree completely from the earth cave.
Yes. So he want to emphasize on this fact, okay? He wants to emphasize on this fact, yes, that all these processes are not adequate, not sufficient to kill a tree from its complete root. It is not killed. It is still surviving. Okay? Yes, to kill a tree, we have to eradicate it completely. We have to eradicate its root as a whole. And it requires a lot of stamina. It requires a lot of time, efforts. Clear? Now, next question we have is, what is the meaning of anchoring earth and earth cave? Have you written these points?
Yes.
Shall I move further? So we have fifth answer. What is the meaning of anchoring earth and earth cave? Anchoring earth. First of all, write down the meaning of anchoring earth. What is the actual meaning of anchoring earth? I have told you also. Yes. To hold securely with roots. Okay? So basically the meaning of anchoring earth means the roots which are not, you can say, visible. These are not visible. These are hidden. And where it is hidden? In the earth. These are found under earth crust.
Beneath the earth.
Okay. So this is denoting anchoring earth. Okay. And after that we have earth cave. It is same like that. Earth cave is also same like that. What can be this? Whole cluster of roots. One and the same thing. Whole cluster of roots. Okay, that is also. Yes. So you can say the soil and roots. They have a very hard grip. They have a very
hard grip.
And they are completely joined all together. They are regarded as a whole part. And they are so stuck to each other that it has a very strong, very, you can say, firm grip. It has a very strong and firm grip. And it is very much difficult to take it out. Clear? So as if somebody wants to hide, so cave gives it a shelter. Cave, any animal, if it wants to hide, so cave gives a shelter to that animal. So in the same way, earth is considered as a cave. So why this? Suppose it is a tree and these are roots, and roots are going so deep. So this part is considered as a cave. Why it is considered as a cave? Yes, because it is providing shelter to a tree. It is providing. Yes, it is providing shelter to a tree. So that's why it is considered earth's cave, because its roots are spread in soil, and soil and roots both collectively giving a shelter to a tree. And this shelter is provided by whom? This shelter is provided by earth. So that's why it is given a name, earth's cave. Clear? So you frame this answer. Because earth is giving it protection. It is giving a place to tree. Otherwise, outer part of a tree, which is visible, it can be cut at any time. But its roots are spread widely and they can come out, they can grow at any time. So this earth is just like a cave. It is giving a protection, it is giving a shelter to whole of the tree. Okay, because its life is there. Okay. So this question is clear. Shall I move further? Now, next question we have, what does he mean by the strength of the tree exposed? Try to understand the phrase first of all. The strength of the tree exposed. Okay. The strength of the tree, it means, first of all, listen, what is the strength of the tree?
Roots.
In simple words, strength of the tree is roots. Okay. And these roots are providing nutrients, air, water, you can say life, it is getting from roots. Okay. It is getting different kind of nutrients from it. That's why it is surviving. That's why it is going up. Okay. And it has taken so many years to survive, isn't it? So it has accumulated so much sunlight, air, and water. That's why it is able to survive. That's why it has taken a proper place. That's why its roots are spread properly. Okay. So we can say, otherwise, when the tree is pulled out of the earth soil, then it will become lifeless. It means here the life is existing. Here the life is existing. If these roots will be pulled out, then life will be no more. It will be killed. Okay. So the strength of the tree exposed, it means these roots should be exposed, should be taken out. Okay. These roots should be taken out, because when these roots will be exposed, what is the meaning of expose here? So what is the meaning of expose? To make visible. Exposed to sun, it means it should be visible, it should be taken out, okay? It should be tangible, it should be clear, okay? Then only we will say that it has been killed. Clear? If roots will be, because the life of a tree is present in it, roots. Clear? Next, and the same thing again, it is being repeated. What finally kills the tree? Simple. So who is going to tell me this answer? Because for this answer, I will not provide you hints. Each and everything is going to be repeated again and again, whatever I'm telling you. So you just prepare this answer. What finally kills the tree? Aparan, you come here and speak your answer.
Pulling out the tree from the earth and scorching and choking it in the sun and the air kill the tree. It becomes brown, dry, and gets hard, and eventually it dies.
Aditya, you come. You
pulling the tree entirely from the earth cave, scorching and choking, it makes the tree, scorching and choking, it makes the tree brown, hardened, and it twisted and decayed at the time then it is dead.
So you have to tell when the roots will be exposed in the sun. Okay, after giving the exposure in the sun, what will be going afterwards? Yes. So you pick up all these points. You pick up all these points, then finally tree will be killed. So it is given in the last stanza. Pick up words from the last stanza. How the tree is going to be killed? When roots will be exposed. Okay. Now roots are exposed. After roots are exposed, it means it is going to die. But afterwards, what will happen? Yes, it will start scorching. Scorching, it will choke. Because it will not be able to, choke means it will not be able to breathe properly. It will not be able to breathe properly. Its color will change. Color will change.
Brown.
Yes, what color will be there?
Brown.
It will become brown in color. Internal part, roots. Roots are white. If you see the roots which are white spread, these are little bit of white color also. So they will become dry. They will become dry. And dry, they will become hard. And after that, color will become brown. Because they will not get proper moisture. So no moisture will be there. No moisture will be there. No water will be there. So it will start decay. And it will start bending. Bending also. Twisting also. So you have to pick up all these words to write down your correct answer.
It will become hardened.
Yes, it will become hardened also. So you will pick up all these points. With the help of these points, you will be able to frame the answer. Clear? So scorching, choking, not able to breathe, color will change, it will become brown, it will become dry. Okay, no moisture will be there, no water will be there. With the passage of time, its twigs will also start bending, its shape will also change, it will decay with the passage of time, and at last it will become only a bundle of hard substance. It will become a bundle of hard substance. So it means now it is a lifeless. It will become a lifeless hard substance. So this process will be known as decay. So when this decay process will be done, it means tree is killed completely. Withering is also like that. It is decaying. So here with decay, you can also write down withering. So bachche, if you will be using such kind of all these vocabulary words, you'll be adding all these details in your answer, only then your answer will be considered complete. Otherwise, not complete. So you will not be able to get good marks. If you really want to score good marks, you have to put efforts. You have to pick all these words and write down. Ek Jyot is so busy in typing the answers. So Ek Jyot, whatever you have typed, it is absolutely correct. Very nice. I think you should attend offline classes. Google chalega to she will be able to write on notebook, because now she is typing so long answers in chat box. It is not screenshot. She has to. But I think the language she has written, it is not a Google language. It is, she has framed. Okay.